Hello everyone, welcome back. This is the day the Lord has made and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you so much for tuning in. God bless you. Today's message, your Father wants your star to shine for everyone to see. And if you are new here, I say welcome. On this channel, you will find inspiration, direction, motivation to keep you going in this walk with the Lord. So go ahead and subscribe so that you don't miss out on anything God is doing in this family. We are moving forward by fire in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's get straight into it. The prophetic word for today is about letting your star shine. How are you going to do that? Through prayer. Because if it's not shining, something is happening around your destiny that is causing your star not to shine. So this is the word for you today. And your prayer today should be, let my star shine, O God, for all to see. This prophetic word is coming from Matthew chapter 2, verse 2 to 12. I want you to go and read the whole passage. I want us to look at verse 2. This is the story when Jesus was born, and Herod could see through that star that Jesus was born. In verse 2, it says, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." Herod knew that the King of the Jews was born through that star. The star was shining so bright that no one could miss it. And this is what I want to talk about today. Let's look at the Herods of your life. Herod represents your star hunters, those who are hunting your star for evil. The moment you were born, your star was shining so bright. And because of that, the enemy went hunting for your star. Without your knowledge, your parents didn't know what was even happening. This is in the spiritual world. So no one sees what is happening. You see a child born a star. And what happens down the line? That child is no longer shining. That child will grow up suffering and wandering in the world as a wandering star. After watching this video, go and pray and say, "Lord, wherever my star has been caged, let it jump out by the fire of the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, the Holy Spirit can go out there and search and take your star out of any cage. Let the power of the Holy Ghost locate your star. Let it begin to shine for everyone to see." And many Christians today think that once they are born again, that's it. Everything will just fall in place. That is not true. You will need to keep on praying. Pray without ceasing. That's what the Bible says. The enemy is always rolling to and from, to seek whom to destroy. He destroys once the child is born. He steals that star. He cages it. And then you are not able to fulfill your purpose here on earth. Thou star of my destiny, begin to shine in the name of Jesus. Let that be your prayer now. This word is about Jesus, but it's also a prophetic word for you today. Many things are happening in your life because someone hunted your star for evil. This scripture says, "Where is the one who has been born king?" When you were born, there were Herods in your life. Your parents didn't know about it. And they were there. Where is the one who has been born great? Where is the one who has been born successful, prosperous, a world changer, prophet to the nations? You were born a star. And then the enemy sent his own messengers as if they were there to present gifts before you or before your parents. They were there to rejoice with you, and yet the motive was wrong. That's why you have to be careful who you surround yourself with, who you give information to. You have to ask the Holy Spirit to give you the spirit of discernment. Be prayerful all the time. Mothers who are pregnant, you have to pray every single day. Anoint yourself. Cover yourself with the blood of Jesus Christ. Read Psalms 91 aloud before you go to bed during the day. Put on the full armor of God. That baby must be protected because you don't know where these Herods are. They will come pretending to bring gifts to you. They did it to Jesus. You want the star of that child to be protected. The star of that unborn baby to shine brighter for everyone to see. You are bringing a child to this world. And you want that child to be a world changer. Remember Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse 5. It says, "I knew you before you were born. I ordained you that you will be a prophet to the nations. You were meant to be great, a mouthpiece of God, a vessel that would change nations." But you are still wandering. Your star is still wandering. You are going about life confused. This is what happens when your star has been caged, when your star is not shining anymore because it is hidden somewhere. This prophetic message comes from a dream that I had. The Lord showed me a woman. This is someone I know. And it was like we are just having a conversation, and she took me into her house and she said, I want to show you something. And she opened the drawer, showed me something that looked like a stuffed animal. And I said, what is this? It was purple in color. She said, this is what I use to cage people's destinies. You want to try it? I said, okay, let me try it. And she said, squeeze it. And I squeezed it towards her, and the person started to get confused. I stopped and the person became normal. I tried it again. This person became mad, like she wanted to go mad. She was even running away. And I said, but why? That's how I control people's destinies. When I woke up, I went straight and wrote the dream. I didn't know that God was giving me a word, because every time I want to share something, I pray that God reveals what I should speak. This word is not mine, and I don't want it to come from my own self. Because when the word of God comes, it's powerful. It's life-changing. This dream puzzled me so much the whole day. And when I don't get the message, the Holy Spirit will bring it again. I thought it was just a dream, but God was telling me something. That there are heralds in this life whose job is to cage people's destinies. They are not shining because someone somewhere is watching them. I thought that dream was just God to reveal what is happening in the spiritual world. But remember that God seals a message in a dream, and it's up to us to unwrap it, to know what he's talking about. I forgot that I had prayed for God to give me a word. I didn't understand. And the following day I was praying, because he knew that I wasn't going to share this. So he came again for the second time. This time it was a scripture to confirm the dream. This is where it's coming from. And when I was reading about this, Matthew chapter 2 verse 2, it was clear that it was confirming the dream that I had. And the Holy Spirit helped me to understand, and here I am sharing it with you. In this passage, you see how Herod tried to capture Jesus' star. He wanted to kill baby Jesus. He sent these people, not with good intentions, to give the baby good wishes and gifts. It was so that he could go and kill him. Anyone hunting your destiny will not succeed in the name of Jesus Christ. Let those hunters of your star fall down in defeat. Anyone who is speaking against your rising, let them be silenced in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in Isaiah 54, verse 17, the latter part of verse 17 says, any tongue that rises up against you, you will condemn. Anybody speaking evil against your star, let them be silenced permanently in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Jesus' star was seen from afar. Just by looking at this star, Herod knew that Jesus was the Messiah, that the King of the Jews was born. Just by looking at your star when you were born, destiny diverters knew that you were going to be great. Wherever your star has been caged, it has to jump out now by the fire of the Holy Ghost. Herod was not able to kill Jesus. His star could not be stopped from shining. He is within you. He is your Savior. He is your Redeemer, and is able to deliver you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Say, oh Lord, let my star begin to shine for all to see. As Jesus' star shined so bright that everyone knew where he was, that star was directing people. That star was guiding them. Let your star begin to shine from today in the name of Jesus Christ. If you are pregnant, declare the word of God that your baby is covered by the blood of Jesus Christ, covering you in the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Jesus, King of the Jews, was born, and his star could not be stopped from shining. Your star will not be stopped from shining. All will come and see that you are the child of God. The wise men were directed by Jesus' star because it was shining so bright. Nothing was covering it. These wise men were sent to go and worship the Lord, the King of Kings. When your star is shining, people will locate you. May you be located for favor this week, this month, this year, in the name of Jesus Christ, because your star is jumping out of any cage. No one will succeed to cage your star anymore. Whatever has been intended against your life, let it fall down in defeat. May you succeed in everything you are doing in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray for your children. If you see that there's something wrong around your children, woman of God, stand in the middle of the night, whatever time you stand to pray. Pray and fast for those children. Those children were meant to be great in this world. Wherever they go, they will succeed. That's what the word of God says in Psalms 112 and verse 1 to 3. When your star is shining, you are connected with greatness. You are connected with those who are meant to help you. Your name will be impressed upon their minds. They will remember you. They will see you wherever you are. Let your light shine. Let favor come your way. Let divine helpers locate you. Let those who are supposed to advance your destiny begin to see you. Thou star of your destiny, begin to shine now in the name of Jesus Christ in whatever you are doing, whether you are looking for marriage or it's a business, whatever you are doing in your career, let that star shine and shine brighter. Whatever is in your hands right now, let it increase because of Jesus you are carrying inside of you. Nothing will succeed to dim your star. The light of the Holy Spirit is able to cause that star, wherever it is caged by evil ones, to jump out in the name of Jesus Christ. When you were born, any power that tempered with your life be destroyed in the name of Jesus Christ. Some people say you cannot pray against your enemies. Psalms 35 talks about David praying against his enemies. Let all those who are hunting your star and blocking it from shining be defeated in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the path of your enemies be dark and slippery. That's what the word of God says. David, a man after God's heart, was able to pray like that. Why can't you? You should pray against your enemies. You cannot let them be tampering with your destiny and making your children be wandering stars in this world, and you are just seated. Woman of God, stand in your home. You've been appointed. You've been assigned as an angel in that home. Stand to pray. Pray for your children. Let your children succeed in everything they are doing in the name of Jesus Christ, because this is the will of God. From today, your star shall not be dimmed anymore in the name of Jesus Christ. Arise and shine. Let the glory of God be shining over you, over everything you touch. Lift your hands and say, I belong to Jesus. As Jesus could not be stopped, I cannot be stopped in the name of Jesus Christ. Manderia, Oria Kalabaya, Jende Mariandu. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the living God. You are successful. You are prosperous. You are moving forward by fire. Nothing can stop you anymore in the name of Jesus Christ. Whoever is the herald of your life, let them fall down in defeat by the power of the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. You've been given power because you are called born again. You are calling upon the name of the Lord. No power anywhere will succeed against your destiny. In Jesus' name, you were born to shine. You will not be found among those who are confused. Your mind is sound. Now begin to speak over your mind, over your destiny, over everything you are. And by doing that, you are positioning yourself for favor. Let divine helpers begin to locate you because your star is shining bright. Pray, oh Lord, connect me with my divine helpers. Let those who are meant to move me forward locate me now in the name of Jesus, not by power nor by might, but by the power of the Holy Ghost. Wherever God has positioned you, He has positioned you there for a purpose. Whatever you are doing, rejoice and be glad and say, I appreciate my God. I am an accountant and I will do my best in this career to glorify my God. Wherever you are, let your life shine. And this is what I had to share with you. Begin to shine from today. Arise and shine, because the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. Do not be defeated. You are meant to defeat the enemy. You are shining in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you for taking time to comment, like, and share. Watch more videos that I recommend at the end of this video. You are being part of spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ. Be blessed, and I'll see you in the next one.